Hello friends, welcome to my super learning channel. Today we are going to discuss about how to use Trello app. Trello is an application for organizing the project management activities and tasks, which is available in the web application format as well. This comes with a kind of sticky notes where we stick onto the board. In our real life, the same way, this is a digital sticky note application that can be used to organize our tasks, day-to-day activities efficiently. Let's get started. In this exercise, I'm going to show you how to create a board and then how to use a template, and then we will move on to using a real life project management example. You can see the recently created boards are listed there, and when I click the create button, I get a board of this nature. So the first set of things that we see in the screen are the lists. To the list we can add our cards. Within the cards you can embed your label. That's how it works. So when I click the plus icon, I can add one more list to my existing budget board. Here I am creating charity as my list. And now I am going to add few cards under my bills. I'm going to create a couple of bills gas, electricity, and so on. Under the savings, I'm going to create my systematic investment plan, SIP, and then my recurring deposit, RD. Coming to loans, I'll be creating my education loan and then a vehicle loan. Charity I have created as a placeholder for now. So this doesn't give much of a sense to me because I just created the categories, but how I am going to use is the key. I'll show you by editing one of the card items. So if you want to just change the label or label color, some of the cosmetic things, you can just edit the label text, or you can double click the label itself to edit the description and other workflow features. Here I am just going to set my label color. Which is not required as such. I just click the electricity card and it shows the features to edit the description itself, and I can change the workflow. Now I am again selecting the gas. Either I can go and change the title itself there. We will leave it as it is for now. But I can go and add some description so that when I share this card with someone else, they can understand the purpose of this card. And the activities, these are the key things. And I can even set the due date and time so that it will set a reminder for me a day before or whenever I want. An email notification will be sent to the recipient. The color code currently shows as orange, and when it is overdue, it becomes red. Now I am adding some activity notes so that the other person in my team or the members that I am sharing this board will be notified. Vice versa, the person who adds the comments or take any actions on this card will also notify me in the similar way. You can explore the other features. You can either go and attach your bills, and you can even add some more detailed checklist to the task so that you can mark that as complete perfectly when it is done. So this example is just to show you what or how the cards looks like, and then how you can add a list, how you can add a label or something like that. But the real example, the purpose of doing this is little bit different. I'll show you another example. I'll create a project management board and then create some of the activities and track the workflow. Here I have changed the charity to completed. So now you can see I can drag and drop the sticky notes. This gives me a lot of flexibility in managing my workflow. Also notify the persons who are contributing to this board, and it is digitally you are communicating with or collaborating with the team without having to personally go and assign a task or work with them. Now I am going to create another example, which is for the project management. So let's create a team. I can create a project team name. I want to name it as Project A. And then I can choose the type of the team. Here I will be picking the project management as the purpose. The team. I can even have some description. Here I can add the team members by adding their email address. It could be either official or their Gmail account. I'll do it later. For now, I'll be the only member in this team. You can see my team is created now. And within the board, I can even use some of the existing templates. But I want to create my own. I'll be again naming my project A and make it as a private for now. Okay. If you make it public, it will be shared with the other people. Here I will be categorizing my task lists into three categories: to do, doing, and then done. And within to do, I'll be adding few more cards. A set of activities that I want to perform. I want to create a home page. I also want to create a graphical icon for the logo of my website. And start with all the activities in your to-do list. And when you start doing, you can drag and place those cards into the doing activity. And when it is done, you can move it to done, so that the entire workflow is maintained and tracked within the system. Now let me edit and show you how I can use this card. I pick one of the card and I'm writing some activity. If I use that symbol, it will automatically show me the list of members who are available within this board. So in this case, I'm the only person, so I'll be typing my name and then I'll set some comments. So when the other member visits this, they will be knowing what activity I have performed within this task. Let me also add some description. Please keep the title as short as possible so that it's clear in the board. And I set some due date as well for this task. Now you see the date is set along with the time. Now I am adding some activity to the card and then I'm saving it. You will see the comments history is tracked and maintained. I can do the similar things for other parts as well. Now you can see one comment is shown against the comment icon and the due date is also highlighted. So I'll be moving some of the cards to doing. And once the work has been done, I can go and set the status as complete. Let me show it to the first one. I have completed the homepage creation. So by checking the checkbox, I'll mark it as complete. You can see it turned into green with a complete status and flag. That's how this Trello board works, and you can have as many cards as you want, you can create as many lists you want, but make it simple so that it makes perfect sense for you to organize your work and then collaborate with your team. This can even help you to organize some of your grocery list that you want to share with your spouse. And whenever you go for shopping, you can add some of your shopping cart list and you can mark it as complete once your shopping is done. And if you like this video, please share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you, friends.